Hey there, I'm Valerie Knowles from Knowles Produce, and today I'm going to tell you all about one of my very favorite shrubs, euonymus. I know, it's a tongue twister. Just remember, it sounds like hippopotamus, euonymus. This is Silver King euonymus. There are several different varieties of euonymus. This is one of my favorites because it's green with white edges. I love it. So here's why this guy is so amazing. Number one, full to part sun. It can take your hot sun area in your yard. It can also take some light shade. It doesn't have to be full sun all day, but it can handle it. Number two, it does not drop its leaves in the winter. So you will have this great looking plant in the winter too. Number three, the color is just incredible. I am a big fan of color in the garden, but I understand that having to completely rip out all your annuals every year and replace them with fresh annuals, it can get quite costly and it can get quite time consuming. So I'm a big fan of putting some shrubs in your garden that will give you some color from leaves that are there all the time. And this is one of those. So it keeps its leaves all year. It does not drop them in the winter, so you get this amazing color in January, in February, in March, when there's not a lot of other color in the garden, all right? One of the other reasons that I love this so much is it's very easy to shape. If you didn't do a thing in the world to it, it would be kind of like this one is, where you see a couple wild hairs coming up, but for the most part, you know, it's not, these are kind of wild hairs. It maybe ends about here. If you didn't do a thing in the world to it, it would end up, I want to say, around 6 feet by 6 feet after maybe 15 years. Now that's just off the top of my head in practice, maybe not in a, you know, in a botanical garden environment. And that's if you really didn't trim it. But this guy, you can trim. You don't have to be a special arborist to trim this. You can go out and maybe once a quarter at most, or once a year at least, and just shape it, right? You don't need any big fancy tools, because even at its most mature, the branches are not super hard, so you don't have to have big giant clippers to take care of this, and you just go out and you trim it to shape. Once you watch this video and you can kind of recognize this a little bit better, you'll start to notice this in a lot of commercial properties where they want a really nice manicured look, where they trim it, you know, pretty frequently to give it that tight condensed, you know, condensed growth look. I love them. They're also pretty inexpensive for a plant like this. At my shop, now it can vary across the country, but at my shop, this is at the mid to low price point of comparable shrubs. I think this guy is around $30-ish, something like that. And it's already relatively big, right? You can put it in your yard and it looks like something. It grows pretty quickly too. It can grow, gosh, 18 inches a year. Now, I will say that with an asterisk. It's not 18 inches of full dense growth a year. And if you're out there trimming it once a quarter, it's not going to be 18 inches of growth. But if you let it go for a couple years to grow as big as it wants, it'll grow probably 18 inches. So pretty aggressively. But it's not invasive. You're not going to have problems with it traveling to areas of your yard that you don't want it. Now here's some tips for care. Number one, when you plant it, use a starter fertilizer so you can get those roots really good and going. We like Espoma's Biotone Starter Plus here. Use whatever starter fertilizer you like the best. So use a good starter fertilizer down with those roots when you get it going. Number two, water it with your hose on trickle for probably about, I don't know, maybe 3 to 5 minutes, 1 to 2 times a week for the first summer that you have it planted, right? And that's pretty much the rule for all newly planted shrubs. Once they're established, you don't have to babysit them so much with water, but for that first summer, plan on watering them quite a bit, right? I like the method of having your hose on trickle, just sit it at the base and walk away for a few minutes so that water really has the time it needs to just slowly seep down into the entire root ball of that plant, right? So water it 1 to 2 times a week for 3 to 5 minutes with your hose on trickle for the first summer. Every year thereafter, if we have a really hot spell, then go out and do that same method, right? 3 to 5 minutes with your hose on trickle right at the base of that plant, and that'll give it the water that it needs, right? So keep it watered, and then feed it twice a year with, you could use plant tone from Espoma or holly tone. Both are organic, dry, easy to use, slow release fertilizers. But again, use whatever plant food you are most comfortable with. But use the instructions, follow the instructions as directed, and use them as frequently as suggested on the package. I think spring and fall are great times to feed, right? If you see any signs of insect damage from time to time, especially in the summer, you might start to see some little holes from insects. It's not super susceptible to insects, but you know, sometimes it will get a little bit of insect problem. Use whatever chemical, if you are a chemical user, that you feel most comfortable with to control those insects. There are plenty of organic options on the market. There's conventional ones too, if you like using the big dogs. But just give it a quick spray in the early morning or in the evening when the sun goes down, and to treat it, and it usually responds pretty darn well. Now, this guy does not have big, showy flowers. It gets some really teeny tiny, small, white to light yellow flowers in the early spring, but they're not really showy. So you might not even notice them when it has it. But it's just great. I love having these in the front of a house, maybe under your front windows. They're easy to manage the height so they don't creep up above your window, and it gives you that fantastic color. So I hope you might find a place in your yard for an edition of this guy. Again, this is called Silver King Euonymus. Sounds like hippopotamus. There are other varieties on the market. There are straight green varieties. And another favorite of mine is called Aureo Marginata Euonymus. And that has yellow edges instead of white. All are fantastic choices, and they all work really well in our Zone 7 climate here in Northern Virginia. Thanks, and I will talk to you next time. Bye-bye.